Okay, so the next part I need to do is solder the connections onto the speed controller, and that's the battery input, the transmitter control cable, and the speed controller connection. Okay, so I've cut some heat shrink tubing, slid that over into those, and here I have an extension lead for the mini servo extension, but I'm going to cut off one end because I don't need that end. Okay, and I'll solder it straight onto there. But first I need to tin these ends. So, soldering iron. The negative pins are on the inside and the positive pin on the outside on this one. Should have started on the negative side first. Okay, that's those one. Now I'm going to just pull these ends off. Solder them onto there, and then I'll move the heat shrink. The three colours are obviously red, the centre one is positive, orange is the signal, and brown's the negative. All you need to do with your fingernails is pull enough off the shrink on there. Tiny little strands together. So I did notice the negative one. Right. Right, time to put them on. Yeah. Now, head on there. Okay. Heat shrink. Okay, now that will come off, so go again. No need to bother with that centre pin, put the sleeve in over there, there's no point. If negative touch negative, it's fine. You do need to put one on the positive and the signal. Don't bother to do that. Okay, so that's the power connection. And my radio connection done. Now I've got to do the other side, which is for the motor. So again, I need to tin both sides. And I need to tin this. Now this, quite clever. I've got that on there. And I've had to bend the two outer pins out so they'll reach with that. Put some solder on them. Now carefully line these up and solder them on the end. If I'm lucky, looks like I've got one connected there. I'm lucky I'll get them. Right, that should pull off now, there you go, so, there you go. So now the beauty of that one, is if the motor is running in the wrong direction, I can simply just turn it round.